the second part of today's lesson is talking about lighting. You can't take a picture without having proper lighting. You can't take a picture without light at all. And there is ways to take pictures where you're out at night and you slow your shutter down, or you do some stuff in a manual camera where you can get a lot of light out of an area that doesn't have much light. But for the sake of today and for the sake of becoming really good as a photographer in general, we're gonna pretend that that doesn't exist and take it right down to the basics, which is just understanding what the light is and where it comes from. There's two types of main light. One is direct light, which could be a light pointing at somebody, a light in a room that's just directly on somebody, somebody holding a flashlight at you, sunlight that's direct and just right on you. And then the other is soft light, and that's the amount of light that comes in not directly on somebody. So an example of that is the shade. So shadows in the shade, light coming in through a window, but the sun not shining straight through that window is also a good example of soft light. When it's cloudy outside, you'll notice soft light as well. What I would suggest doing is when you go out on a photo walk, and I do photo walks all the time, think of a couple things you like that you want to take some pictures of, and when you're walking around, notice the shadows. When it's really sunny out, you'll notice that your shadow or the shadows coming off of trees or things around you are going to be very dark and very definitive of what they are. And on a cloudy day, those shadows are going to almost not even be there. You may not see your shadow at all. And this is very important because when you're taking a picture of different things, the type of light that's hitting your subject is really going to set the mood. If you have a very sunny day with a hard sun coming from one side, the other side of somebody's face could be a shadow. If you wanted to set a really good mood, you could take a picture from the shadow side and have the other side kind of hidden. Or you could take a picture straight on where it looks very dramatic because half of their face is a shadow. But you wouldn't want to do that with like a family photo or a nice portrait of a friend or something like that. That's where soft light is very important, because you can use the gentleness of the shade outside or the gentleness of window light coming inside to be able to make somebody look very appealing and make skin tones look nice, and there's no shadows and creases on wrinkles of somebody's face. It just makes them all look really good, and the soft light complements them. When people shoot weddings or they shoot romantic photos, they tend to be driven towards the soft light because it makes a picture look a lot more beautiful. People who are trying to set moods more will generally use shadows and hard light to be able to create a lot of contrast in a photo. And the contrast is the difference between the highlights and the shadows in your picture that creates a lot of drama. So again, direct light, lights that are just around pointing at you, spotlights, sunlight, things like that, that create a very hard light, create drama, they create shadows, they create a lot of mood in a photo, if that's what you're into. And soft light is just subtle light that kind of comes into a room through a window, it's in the shade near a fence outside, it's during a cloudy day, and that stuff is to be able to take very beautiful, more subtle looking photos. Both are important depending on what you're taking pictures of. You can also create light. And I don't want to talk about the camera flash that's built in or the flash that's built into your phone, because those are just spotlights that flash at somebody. They don't really complement anything. They kind of bring out a little bit of detail, but they make the picture very flat and very boring. If you had a lamp in your house, or you had like a hard sunlight coming in, and you put that lamp or you had that sunlight beside your subject or just off the front so it's not directly at their face, you'll notice that between that and using the flash that's built into a camera, as soon as you move the shadow off to one side, it gives a lot more detail. It makes the picture look a lot more professional, and it's a super easy way to take a studio looking photo without really having a bunch of equipment. You can just do it with your phone. So how do you find available light? Well, it's everywhere. If you look around, there's always available light coming in somewhere. You can move your subject wherever that available light is. It's a lot easier to move who you're taking a picture of or what you're taking a picture of over to a light source that's gonna make them look really good than it is to try to move a bunch of lights around somebody to take a good picture. So when you're out on a photo walk, look for light, look for shadows, find different angles and perspectives to take a picture of. And keep in mind that a picture that looks kind of boring, if you just look at a scenery and it just doesn't look interesting, if you focus on a little tiny thing, the picture of whatever this is that looks really good doesn't matter. It doesn't matter about what's around it, because you found the thing that looks good. Nobody sees the photo of everything around it. Maybe you're taking a picture of a flower, but there's a trash can beside it. If you focus just on the flower, it's gonna look like a really good picture. And if you're close, you're gonna have that blurred out background, it'll look good. But if you took a wide picture, then you just see this flower off in a field with a garbage can beside it, it's not gonna look very interesting. Find those little details of things and get nice and close to your subjects and take pictures of them that way. And don't forget, the framing techniques you learned in the first lesson can be applied to these focus and lighting techniques from today to be able to make that same picture look even more interesting. You'll find that just with these two lessons, taking pictures and keeping all this stuff in mind, your pictures are gonna start looking really, really good, and you're just at the basics. So imagine what happens if you keep practicing with this and you start learning the manual techniques and getting even more comfortable with your cameras. It's gonna be amazing. But that's it for today. Those are kind of the technical things we're gonna talk about. On the next lesson, what we're gonna do is talk about inspiration. How to find inspiration. Once you've found that inspiration, make it look interesting, make it tell a story. So next lesson, we're gonna find that inspiration and turn it into something really artistic. I'll see you then.